see if it's on, I can tell Joey, you know, if there's another week, I can submit a proposed cost model for the summer day camp that may address all concerns. I know that doesn't help right now, but I wouldn't have it done anyway. I think what needs to be nailed down is both structure by the week.
We did.
What's the proposed structure by the week?
The activity?
That's not on my study list.
I don't think so. I think so, a few things that we're talking about, was the idea of allowing people to have the option of paying by the week. I think is what, was kind of what she was talking about.
Okay.
Is my understanding. So what we had proposed to do on the agenda tonight was mostly about money, so kind of unfortunate. Camp pricing, teen camp, and then, then she asked people if they wanted to be alternates. So, well, and it's kind of funny because you two guys were at the budget committee meeting, so it's kind of repeating what I had said, but I can show you. So what I worked up here in my chicken scratch about teen camp, so let's go to teen camp first, was that I have a kind of a side-by-side of, a side-by-side of what our costs are for 15 kids and what our costs are for 20 kids, and then how that works out per week for tuition. I don't know if we should be doing any of this or even bothering. I mean, what do you guys, I mean,
well, yes, we can discuss it, make recommendations,
and vote on it, because you're dealing with the money issues.
Right.
But structure and stuff, totally, you know.
So what I did was take what Jody had done and kind of went backwards from it and did cost per person per week for bus, payroll, pool, and then I added in the fourth, which was the different pricing of each field trip. So that we would have, and this is good that we're talking about it, because it, what are your feelings, I guess, about having different pricing per week according to activity?
What would be? Is there an average?
Yes, I did do an average.
Okay. What was the average for today?
The average came out to, if there are 15 kids in the camp, it came out to 136.
Okay.
If there were 20 kids in the camp, the average was 111.
136 average per week for 15, right?
Yes.
And 20 kids average was
11.
What was your cheapest week?
The cheap week,
just go back to the second. Your constants are staffing, busing?
Staff, bus, pool, fee. Those are the three constants that I did.
Okay, and then the variables would be
activity.
Okay, thank you.
So there were 3 weeks of the cheaper weeks. Now, that can change too, whether we decide. So this is basically the activities that Jody and I had kind of looked into. And I tell this to you guys on my way out, but I had looked up right before the budget committee meeting that Canopy Lake State Park is $26 for the day. If we have, I think it's 20 kids. Don't quote me on that though. So some of these groups, you have to have a minimum, and it's like 20 or 25. But Canopy Lake, I know, offers free chaperone admission for groups of 10. So for some reason, I think it was a group with 25, but then they gave you two chaperones for, so I was kind of funny about that. I was like, well, that's kind of silly. You're going to need another chaperone for 25, but.
is the committee okay with a 10-1 ratio for that cheap camp?
Yeah,
I think that's perfectly fine.
I'm gonna break the fourth wall as an educator.
I would say depends on the kid.
That's a good point.
My son's not there.
My twin is.
But we can never get any 4-to-1 ratio.
Your kid, I'm loving.
Who, mine?
They are.
Her twins are probably the same age, they're the same group.
I don't know your kid.
No, yeah.
Okay, so,
So this is a new camp we're doing, like 12 to 15-year-olds.
They should be fine.
Right. And I think I called Jody when we had a conversation that, and I don't honestly remember who was telling me, but they were at some place and their check-in with their chaperone, they essentially checked in with their chaperone by taking a selfie and of the four of them together, cause, or whatever, the needs travel together, and then they sent it to their chaperone. And yes, the four of us are still here and alive. I think they had to be somewhere in front of something so that they knew where they were, but I don't know.
So I did talk to a parent whose daughter is going to be 12 over the weekend, and they have two children. One would be in the younger kids camp and one would be in the older kids camp, the teen camp.
Yep.
There was a little bit of discussion and questions that came up in my mind about, she sent her older child to camp last year and went 5 days a week. And now we're sending it back to 3 days a week. Can she sign her daughter up for the 5 day a week camp if they're 12 still, or is it only the teen camp?
Well, what we were discussing was that if they want to go to Camp Raleigh on those off days, they're more than welcome to, they have to wear the shirt. So the staff will be able to distinguish the difference. And then they can be almost like a, I don't want to use them as a junior counselor, but kind of a junior counselor. They can hang out with their friends and be off to the side and be on their phone and whatever and just enjoy each other's company without being bothered by the little kids. And the little kids would know that they aren't in their shoes. Because the staff is still going to be kind of a crossover sometimes. We're still working that part up too. Because we may have a part-timer of teen camp
counselor
for 3 days full time.
Right. That would go 2 days because the other team.
Right.
And
I'm hesitant about what you're saying, though, Jody. I am hesitant about giving them freedom and options in Camp Raleigh. I think there are some kids that who are 12 that might be better off suited in Camp Raleigh. I don't know if we should necessarily, I think 12-year-olds almost, we should give them an option. Where do you feel your child is best suited?
So you want Camp Raleigh from kindergarten to 12 years old, no, first grade to 12 years old, and teen camp from 12 to 15?
Yeah.
Or do you want to make teen camp 13 now?
No, because I think the parents should have the option on the 12-year-old. Because, like, last year with my 12-year-old, she definitely should have been, like, in a teen camp. But I know that there are some parents who would definitely say, no, that's not a good place for my kid.
And that's what the parents do with the kid.
Right.
I want to be here.
Well, because then if you have, like, Celia's saying, if you have a parent who thinks their 12-year-old should be supervised 5 days out of the week, then I feel that that parents should have their child in the full day camp, probably.
Okay. And this parent could say, I'm probably signing both my kids up for Camp Raleigh this summer without hesitation. And then I said, well, they are introducing, we're thinking about introducing a teen camp. And the comment was made, well, my older child will probably like not having to hang around with their younger siblings.
Yeah. That's an interesting discussion. I think, and it almost it goes back to another person with grade school. It's like some people should be in middle school for sixth grade, but others should not, you know? So that is kind of a, yeah, it's definitely that's a good scenario that
if the fee is so high already, I wouldn't want to charge them anymore. But if they want to be there, then they do, I would want them to be in their shirt. And so the counselors know what age group they are and either use them as a junior counselor or something to that effect.
Well, the shirt though, that would be, so if we keep our Tuesday, Thursday schedule, our Tuesday schedule of field trip, that would be a field trip day. That's right. So that would be an extra cost that we would have to take into account. I think you've got to go one or the other. I don't know if we could do that.
Yep. It's hard enough getting two camps going.
What do you think, Kathy?
I'm quiet.
But you are quiet. What do you think?
I'm not sure. I think these people, you know, working out both ways.
I think that they're just at the point now where the older child is walking home independently. The younger child is not old enough to walk home, but the older one's walking home, and the moment they walk in the door, nobody's there, but they have to call to check in and say, I'm home.
Yeah.
So the parent, by the spring, by the time camp starts, they may be more comfortable letting them be home all the three times.
So my feeling on that and knowing what your kid, like most of like Shelby's friends did not attend camp this past summer, that they're parents were, they were like, no, we're not going to spend the money, and my kids are old enough to be at home by themselves all day and doing whatever, you know. So I think if you can approach a parent like that with saying, well, do you feel comfortable leaving your child home all day alone while you're at work? And if their answer is no to that, then they belong in camp probably. And I think we should give.
Yeah. I should have a lot of freedom in the teen camp anyway. So.
I think we have to, but I don't think age, at that age, that we should say you should be in one or the other. I think as a 12-year-old, we should say, hey, if you want your kids to camp rally, send them to camp rally. If you want them in teen camp, send them to teen camp. So I think that should be it.
One of the things that I was thinking about when I was making the flyer is, your child has to be 12 as of January 1st, 2017, which makes them 12 and a half by the time they're at teen camp. Because I don't want to go through the, like, in football. Well, my kid's going to be 12 in 3 weeks.
Yeah.
And in the middle of camp, no. This is the cutoff, just like softball, just like baseball, just like everything else. By this date, your kid has to be 12.
And moms for grade school. I know I asked and one of the other parents that petitioned the school, their cutoff date is October 1st, and both of us were in October, and we were told, no, you have to wait another year.
I don't know.
Some districts have their kids out, and if you're at the academic level or the maturity level, they will put you a grade ahead. They'll let each other.
Okay. So for the teen camp, let's go back to the teen camp. What was your cheapest day again?
So, yeah, if there are 3 weeks that are go, that would be 120 for 15 kids or 100 for 20 kids. That's a pretty significant drop in my opinion. So if we can get 20 kids, it would be pretty awesome.
So when we're marketing this, we can't do we shoot for the 20 kids and then say $100 a week rate? Because if we shoot for the 15 kids and charge 120, it's just an added bonus if we get the 20 kids.
I say we shoot for 100. We shoot for 15 and do the 120 rate, and then if we have the extra money, it's something that we can use to indulge the campers or do something else fun. It's extra cash that we can use.
Or, I don't know, I say, you might want to advertise for high, right, but say, possibility that this, I don't know.
I'm not giving money back if it's...
No, but depending on interest, the rate could go down.
No.
No.
Once we get their check, that's it.
No, but before...
Before that happens.
Yeah.
So how do we find that out, how do we get that? Because, okay, so to me, like, as a parent with two kids in this group, when I see the 100 and I see 120, and I multiply that and I have two, so that 200 versus 240 for a week for me.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
You know, that's kind of...
Yeah.
That might, a lower price might get me, so that's a thought, if we keep prices low, that might get me to sign up for a third week where maybe the higher money, I'd only be able to sign up for two.
And what's your most expensive week?
Most expensive week? We could have two of those, but this is the thing, we don't have to. So Jody, the kayaking week that you did, that is $65, right?
Yeah, we can scratch that and throw in the Canby Lake instead or something like
we
that.
We could do Canby Lake for that, so then we would only have...
That was dreaming. Like,
yeah.
I made this and they were in an air conditioned bus and all.
But still, kayaking sounds like a good, fun activity to me.
Yeah.
The Take Flight Day sounds awesome. So they would do $65 for the full day. But again, we could have that if we think that we're not going to get kids, because we could do a 2.5 hour ropes course. That's $27.30 per kid. But if we want to do the full day with the zip lining and the ropes, it's $65.
Let's do the half day this year.
Do the half day.
Yeah.
And then that way we can keep all our costs down.
Yeah.
Although I've had some, probably most people have been like, oh, take flight the whole day?
Oh. Well, we can go a couple of times.
Oh, and you know what? I had a call from Indoor, just to kind of go Indoor sent, finally returned my call. I haven't had a chance to speak to them, so I don't even know. I don't know what their pricing is or what their availability is, but that's...
Yeah, the average is like $30.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Because I thought it was less than that.
You mean Indoor finding?
Yeah, Indoor. Well, I can get back when I talk to the guy. I'll call him tomorrow. But Water Country, like, for the day. So then, if we go take flight, the $30, that's pretty much 30. Water Country for the day was 30. And if we want to do Canby Lake for 30, then really the high price would be $130.
For 15 kids?
Yeah. And $110 for the 20 kids. And then that would actually eliminate. So I had 2 weeks in there. There was $165 for 15 kids, and it was $140 with that big. So yeah, if we want to go half day and do the Canby Lake one thing instead, and a half day to take flight, then we kind of get that real big expense out.
So I went over the summer, or September, to the fair down at the and picked up this summer camp from Mass Audubon, and they have teen camps from 12 to 14, and I was looking it over, and their prices range from $390, $500 for teen camps per week. And one of them they have two teen camps that are canoeing, and one is just hiking, and then one is a survival camp, and learning about the water. So I thought,
you're saying that they're asking $300 a week?
$350.
So that's right.
Yeah.
That's where I'm getting.
And so is, and so is UNH for their travel plan. Lovely. One week is like 200.
Where are all these people? What do they do for a living? I don't know. I'm doing something wrong, I guess. Oh. Well, I could tell you, like, and I told, so I have Summersworth in here. Now, they're not that expensive, but they're,
I think it's really the head of these.
They call it a trend can.
I thought that was a good phrase.
And they, so they go on like 3 field trips a week, and they charge something like $400 to $500 for a half of their summer.
$700 a week.
Yeah.
It's 4 weeks.
Yeah. And I think the second week was a little bit more expensive. I don't know what they're, I could probably.
So that pamphlet goes from.
That mid grade, they have grades in there 6 to 9 is how summer's worth to find it. And their kids can't. Like K-5.
So your most expensive week with 20 kids is 110.
Yeah. Yeah.
Your average, if you average them all out, is 111.
Yeah, but no, because if we eliminate the two expensive trips, so that our average will go down now. Average will probably be, what, it'll be 104, approximately 105.
Okay. Okay. So what if we advertise?
So would it be four of those weeks that we would do that?
I'm afraid of changing the weeks, becoming that year of changing. Like, I don't mind you buying week 1, week 3, week 8, week 6, but if they're all different numbers, that is really confusing. I would like to have a flat rate if we do a per week.
Well, and that might be more doable with these activities. The problem I have with that is basically, you know, the people who aren't going on those expensive trips are basically paying for the kids to go on those expensive trips.
So if we make it a 110 price.
Well, if we eliminate those two big expenses, then you really could do an average.
You really think there'd be that much of a time in there?
We couldn't get to Raleigh Street, no. And that was a flat rate for one-time fee.
Well, how are we going to do, which this could lead us into the next conversation that we were going to have with choosing, having people pay per week for Camp Raleigh. We had talked about that, too.
Oh, and I don't mind because that's a flat rate. As long as it's a flat rate fee, I don't mind them paying per week.
And I think you and I and Dave discussed it out in the hallway one night that if we did a flat rate fee, it was a little cheaper to go pay for about the summer. Or is it?
But how are we going to do a week by week with staff? How are we going to regulate the staff?
We might have to hire more part-time people.
And we can also look at, like,
we know that they're busy or something.
Oh, sorry. No problem. That the 2 weeks that the staff book us off, like when they're starting sports and stuff like that, and know that those weeks we're probably not going to want to fill up as much. Or, like, I don't know, say Kelly's got a camp counselor and then she's got a couple kids in the camp and she's going to go on vacation for a week, then there's 3 other families going on vacation, so that we're not going to fill that slot.
Yeah. Everybody that was hired full time needs time off.
Yeah.
So no one worked. Very rarely did they ever get a full paycheck. The first 2 weeks were the only weeks that everybody got a full paycheck.
Okay.
After that, everybody worked. Right. 1 day less, 2 days less.
Some of them took a week off.
Yeah. $290 the whole summer, which was only $36, $36.50 or something like that. Last year we charged $240, which equaled up to $30 a week. But if we're going to pay for per week, I think it should at least be $40.
Well, let me tell you this, and this way, because I was quite astonished by how Barrington priced out there per week. So, and we might want to think about this. If we want to choose per week, I don't know. I think you have to put something like $75 a week. I mean, that's really what. So this is what they did. The cost for their, this is for a resident, $510 for 8 weeks, right? I did the math at 1.10. I don't even know where it is. $510 divided by 8, so that's $63.75 a week is what Barrington is looking at right now. Their charge, if you're going to buy by the week for a resident, is $150. So they're more than doubling.
So, tell me that again. So Barrington, for the whole summer, is how much?
$510.
$53.10 for the whole summer, which is equal to $63.10 per week. Okay. And then by week,
they charge $150 the full week, again, biweekly. So really, it only makes sense in their camp is if you're going to go to their camp for 3 weeks or less, that it will save you money. Now, they're non-resident, and I don't know if we should go this far, but they charge $610 for the 8 weeks, which is what we did in Hollingsford. We did $100 more. So that comes to $76.25. What they're charging for non-residents for the full week is $250 for the week. So that's a whole $100 more per week. So that case is like it was only more beneficial to do 2 weeks if that's all you're going to do.
Yeah, if we raise it to $50 a week, $400 if you go all 8 weeks. But Michelle is not going to go all 8 weeks. So if we get $50 a week for 7 weeks, it's $350, which is only $90, so $60 more than what you wanted. I think $50 a week is a very good price point for anybody. Every other camp is $100 plus for no matter what.
And you can't get daycare for $50 a week. For some of the kids that might be kindergarten, fourth, first grade, might still go to daycare.
Right. So what are you saying, Jody? You're saying are we to have a flat rate, but then to also offer $50?
Or $50 a week.
Just to have $50 as our charge.
Oh, we not have an option to pay, get a discount if you pay for all 8 weeks.
And then you bring it back down to $290 if you pay for all 8 weeks.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I think $290 is too cheap, and I hate to say that, but when we were looking at how we had to raise money, and I have it somewhere in here, $50 for out of town, there's $50 for in town. I think I looked at 40. Because what we wanted to do, correct, was take away the nickel and diming of the all inclusive, right?
Yeah.
So I think where D was coming up with 290. 90 is our charge last year was 240, right? Which was 30 a week, plus we had our $35 registration fee. Plus if we add $40 to that right off the bat, it's 280.
The buses was 280.
Right. So our kids paid 280, really, plus the 35. So right there, what's that, 325 for one kid? With the 35.
So last year, how you coming to 315?
It was 240
for the camp.
Plus 35 for registration. Plus 40 for the buses. And they paid $5 a week for the buses.
So they really paid 315 last year as a one child household. Now for two kids it was 440. So we did do
440 plus 80, because that was 2 kids.
Yeah.
It's 520 plus the $35 registration was 555.
Right. So 555 was what you paid for the two family.
So
two kids.
It was 35, again, 80. And then how much was it for the two kids?
440.
So it's on. And so that brought us to 510.
555.
555 for the whole summer. Okay.
So last year I only paid 555. And this year I'll pay 700.
And that includes all your busing.
Everybody's had it before. So the registration fee.
Wait a minute. Everybody gets their own format? Yeah, people don't like that. But then it works, but the, we just work the work, I used to do the work, I can't afford the work anymore, but, I have their work sitting in here, what do they charge? They charge, let's see who goes faster.
You will.
$30 registration fee. There's a one-time $30 registration fee for the first camper, and $20 for each additional camper per family. So they.
So we get up to 40 without being.
And that, if we did that, that would cover pretty much everybody that comes to camp except for me.
For all of my work to do.
I get a free shirt.
For all those 12 hours that you put in every week, you deserve it.
I get a free shirt.
Hey, I'm making them pay for that.
Except we can't vote on that, so put that in the minutes for what we want to do.
So, change your registration and administrative fee up to $40 per family, or $25 per child, recommend $40 per family. Make sense?
Yep.
Is that what we're looking at?
So let's add a little more confusion to the thought.
And that covers the teacher, covers teachers for families.
Yep.
Okay.
So let's add the confusion question of, what if we have, which would be my family, right? We have kids in teen camp, we have kids in Camp Raleigh. Is teen camp, are we gonna do a family, I don't know how many kids there would be that we would need to worry about, but we talked about a flat rate registration, is that per family?
For camp, for the.
For the teen camp? There probably will just be a couple people that have more than one.
Yeah.
So flat rate for both?
For both, yeah.
$40 would be for both.
$30 for, yeah.
You want it $40 for teen camp?
No, no.
No, $40 for Camp Raleigh.
Yep.
For camp, well, for registration fee for teen.
Can we talk about 30 with them? Yeah, 30 flat fees, and that gets your shirt, right?
Yeah, we don't put any infringing on where it is, we can get the price point for about $5 or $6.
We can make them shirt. Tie that.
What is battery?
Battery.
I think suggesting the kids would go on to sort of battery and tie that the first week. And then you just.
But they go on a trip the first day.
I love that one.
Unless they feel, how long does it take to make the first?
Right.
So, and they do wanna look all uniform and.
Well, even when we did the shirts for the grade school, they all looked the same, like we did tie-dye one year, but they were all the same color.
Okay.
Tie-dye.
Okay.
And then one year we did spatter painting where the base shirt was the same color and the spatters were a little different. And then we just used stencils to put RGF on them and to put their names or nothing or whatever. Okay. But if you're going away the first day, then that won't work because it has to dry.
Yeah, cause
we're talking that on the.
Is it gonna save us a lot of money?
Bring your own shirt.
I think we just buy it all one color, whatever color we want.
Okay.
And then we get them, you know, bright and sunny.
I don't want white, I'm not letting the teenager go with white shirt.
Well, if you tie-dye.
Tie-dye, that's what I said.
But yeah, if we just buy the shirts in bulk, then in a variety of sizes.
We'll put that on the back burner for now. I like it.
And what did you use for stencils? Just regular?
They just use cardboard and they just held
eliminated. I don't remember. I actually wasn't there when they did those. I wasn't actually there when that happened. One of the kids made my shirt for me. It wasn't any big fancy. So someone will put our dress across the front, and put it down the side, and put it on the back. But if you're not going to put any names on it, it doesn't matter. It could just be all tie-dye in the same color or the same base shirt with bag of painting.
Oh, you
have
one more question.
Shelby did not like your camisole.
I don't
but you don't like that? It's really good.
I thought camo was it.
I know.
I was trying to see if it's fine.
Throw her a plain shirt out of there.
I'm running on. As my mom, I don't.
Oh, no, I was thinking of a green camo or a blue camo or a red camo.
I like the blue.
The blue is awesome.
Apparently.
No, with a whistleaway shirt.
It's not him.
Shelby did not like that.
But she was very polite not telling me the truth when I asked her.
Okay. Okay, yeah.
I need feedback, kid.
$40 now for bus, for other than 360 with the bus. So I think you counted it twice.
Okay, so yeah.
360 with, that includes the busing, plus our 40 would be, so it would be an $80 saving.
What?
She weren't gonna have them pay for the bus.
No, we're.
Not for a week.
We're adding it into the final.
That's what I'm saying. So your $40 a week is gonna make it. So $40 a week times 8 weeks is 320. Right?
Yeah.
And then you wanted to add your buses in again?
No, she's saying $40 a week, no field trips.
Right.
You do payback option.
Right.
And then
you get an increase in fees because of your things that you did wrong.
No, I agree with you. That's what I'm saying. Is that you have to roll in your bus fees into your $40 a week. So it brings it up to what did you say?
So she was saying.
I was just saying we're going to increase it to 40 a week, but then add in the extra bus fees.
And then you pay one lump sum at the beginning.
Right.
For your bus. That week is not included.
So essentially it would be 40.
Doesn't include our bus.
So essentially it would be 45 a week. If you want to include the bus money. It's basically what happened, what that happens to. I just separated it differently. No problem.
I have to work at Amazon pay for a week for the bus. Are we back paying for a week for the bus?
No.
No, she's saying. Separate the buses.
All right, wait, Jody, condense the brain.
I know.
Take the buses out of the equation for right now.
Yes.
320,
yes.
That's 10 times 10.
Yes.
Not including any field trips. If you want to know, and that's just for stay back option.
I'm just for money reasons. I'm just saying we need $40 for busing. So that's why I'm adding in 40.
And then if you want your child to go on the field trip, it's going to be $40. But you have to pay it all up front. Can't pay by week.
No, you got it wrong, I think. I was just thinking, I'm just separating it out for money.
Yes.
Okay. That's all. There are no options, there are no choices. I was just adding 40 at the end because that's our bus fee. That each child needs to pay.
So you're taking 320 plus the 40 for the bus.
Because 40 was bus. So depending on what we charge per week, I guess we really just are charging an extra $5 per week per camper.
So it's 360
right.
A day for all 8 weeks.
Yeah.
All our
yeah.
Long way to get there.
But we're there.
That's okay.
And then you would have a $40 registration fee on that.
Okay.
But that is better. Sorry, Julie.
No, we were on the same page.
It just wasn't coming
we
out the right way.
We weren't speaking the same language. It's okay. We're all there. It's all good. I'm like, wait a minute. Okay.
So really, if you look at all of that, it's
okay.
Well, here's a question.
Are you with us now? Yeah, I'm here. $400.
Good job. So because
it's $45 a week.
Yeah. And then if we do the second child and we subtract, if we want to give them that discount that we have given people, the two kids, I believe would be $680. Because you have $360. And then if you're going to do 35 times the 8, it would be 280. Wait.
$85 a week. Because there's $42 a week. $42.
Right.
So if you have a 10 lesson to take last year. So what are you looking out in your head, Kelly?
I don't understand. So if we charge, the second kid would be $320, so it would be $680 plus one registration fee. Right? Would be $720 for two kids, and that's including registration and opening and everything.
So $360 for first child.
$320 for the second child.
$320.
And then?
For second.
Yeah.
And then, was that total or was there busing?
That was the total. With that included the busing fee.
So your first child is going to pay $360, your second child is going to be $320.
$20, yeah.
And so that's the total of $680, includes busing for the whole summer.
Because that would be $40 each for busing in there, yeah.
Does that cover our...
I actually did that out with Cecilia, and, yeah, actually, I see it goes down here. Yeah, I added in a couple of kids, with our, you know, expanding by maybe 15 kids, and... Yeah, I think we do. Okay, here, that's 40. I think our income would be like around 36.
And three or more kids, do you just want to make it flat, 700?
700 would be less than two kids, though.
Two kids is 680.
What's the 40? Are you including the $40
registration?
I'm not
including any. Okay. Okay. Yeah, because that makes so much change for the
bus. That was included in the fee.
Yeah, but I need more too.
Okay.
Well,
whatever you're going to do with that.
Well, there's not. There's that. Do you know how many families have three more kids? That's three.
Two.
No, it's one.
That was it.
Yeah. So, you want 681?
I would say.
I don't know. How many more of us are in this town now?
That's only, if we go to 700, it's only $20 more than the two kids option.
Well, that's certainly really generous, so I don't know.
I'm fine with that.
I'll abstain from the vote on that one.
Well, you're not going to have three kids in that camp anymore.
Yes, I am.
Oh. But I wonder if that's more expensive for the three kids. It's only one extra kid. She's paying all of her expenses.
Like Kathy was pointing out, she doesn't necessarily cover the bus. For that third kid, if it's only $20.
Okay.
So I think we may go up to $725 and then you cover your bus.
$730.
And then that would cover the bus fee for that kid.
So the third is only $50.
Yeah.
But one would be in another group.
Okay,
17.
Actually, two of them might be new. I was mostly with that person today, I know, but there's a 12-year-old. I don't know if they're going to Raleigh or...
No, you're thinking of somebody else.
Are
you thinking of some of the people right next to me?
One of them, on your sheet. Maybe not the same one you're thinking.
I think you're thinking of someone else.
Yeah. All right, so, we're recommending
you
can't vote. I'm fine with 7:30 for three or more kids.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's going to be our recommendation because we can't vote on anything.
So, 2018, Camp Raleigh for single would be $360, second child would be $680, third child would be three plus child would be $730. And a $40 registration fee.
And that includes all your, that includes your shirt.
And that includes your shirt and your buckets.
Yeah.
And your coat. Yeah, yeah. So the, and so if we set that, let's, do you want to talk about out of town first? Well, all we did last year was out of town was plus 100. I'm still good with that.
So what if the registration including t-shirts and the, so your total for three or more with registration would be 770, include t-shirts and all bus fees, right?
Mm-hmm.
Just making sure. And so 730 for three or more kids is recommended. But that doesn't have to include registration. That's with the registration. Seven.
But, you know, you can't. Can't beat that. I mean, I hate to say that number, but he really doesn't tell me divided by my three kids. It's 256 per kid. And if you divide that by 80, which I won't be yet, but it's 32 bucks a week per kid. I mean,
$385, which is more than the whole.
that's for what, for 7, is that what you're saying? 7 weeks?
15, yeah, 15 weeks. So 55, you say 55?
55, yeah.
55, so 7 weeks, $385.
So it's 1,000.
So you don't even get your 3 weeks.
But you would have 2 kids, so.
Even at 50, so.
But don't you, I don't know, being 1 week out isn't necessarily, do we want to make that less? You want to have that.
Something like 55 weeks. Or self-pay.
Well, 55 weeks to choose, is the way I think about it.
Yeah.
But do you think we should keep it the same rate of 45 a week and just be able to pick your weeks?
That doesn't give anybody an incentive to buy the whole summer.
No.
Oh.
Maybe we have to change the talk about later.
Go back to the flat rate just.
I think Jody, though, unfortunately, you're in a situation that that most of us don't have to think about 10 weeks. You know, so that you are paying more for another 2 weeks of camp, whereas.
Well, not just me, but I'm thinking about the parents that didn't want to pay for the whole summer.
Yeah.
Okay, we have to figure out how that can make, give it a deal for them. We have to.
But if we don't have it, okay, so let's say you have 4, you know, you have kids who or people want to pay for 4 weeks.
4 weeks is $220.
What if we broke it down? I know one of the camps we talked about last year. Did, maybe it was summer, did 2 weeks fall.
Yeah, let's look at summer group. Wait.
And then, so then they did.
Because they do it for a week also.
So you could do like a 4 week block that you know, like the first 4 weeks of the summer, you know, you're going to be there.
That's true.
And then the second 4 week block. And then.
Summer group has a weekly.
Well, if you did only 4 weeks, it's only 220 bucks.
So what they do, so what Summersworth does, their session, so it's kind of hard, they get, one session is more money than another, I don't know why, because they're both 4 weeks, but one of them has a 4th of July in there, and they ask why it's cheaper. So they have a $300 for the first session, and then, but it's $100 a week. So that's a $25 more increase for them. And their second session was $350 by 4 weeks. So that's $87.50 a week, but their weekly rate was $100. So it's $13 more. Their non-residents are $125 a week.
But I think doing 2 sessions at like $220 each, then if you do it that way.
Well, there's more sessions. Other more sessions. 4 weeks.
That doesn't help that.
They still just take their weeks for the big families that don't need a home. But they're not split up because they go 1 week in July, 1 week.
Yeah,
and then that's awesome. And they're still getting, you're still getting what they want. You're still covering the cost.
But if your kids are 50,
yeah,
you're
good.
Yeah, you're
good. Me and you get the shot. We get the free shirt. You know? I know. It's okay. We get the free shirt.
So we're saying we get $55 per week if you.
Let's see what Jody would be.
Jody,
charging you more.
At $35.
right? I still believe in that. That would be $350 for your second kid. $735.
So,
slightly more. It really only makes.
I can bring in a bee.
Yeah.
So, I would still be paying for the whole summer. So,
okay.
It works out with people that only need it once or so.
Yeah.
It works out
with
those two.
Right. Or even 6 weeks is going to.
So, Kelly, tell me the numbers. 55 per week.
55 per week. So, what do you want to know?
Well, for 4 weeks.
Okay, for four.
It is 220.
Yep.
How much is it for all 8 weeks?
No, they wouldn't do 8 weeks, right? Because they would do the flat rate. So let's do, right, so 55 times, let's say 5 weeks, is 275. 55 times 6 is 330. So it really only, you only save money if you're 6 weeks.
Yeah, 330. Per child, right? And then what is your discount for one child? So, with your discount,
do we want to do $5,000? I mean, we've done that for everybody. So, do we want to do that for a weekly payment?
So you first get 55, second kid is 50.
I don't know.
Sure. So that would be 220 plus 200, which would be
420.
420 for 6 weeks. 420.
Yeah.
And then
that's 105 a week.
What's
for 2 kids. 105 times 5 is 530. 6 is 630.
So, just a minute. Where are you? So, this is 2 jobs.
2 jobs.
So, how many weeks are you talking?
6 weeks is 630.
And how much was 5 weeks?
525.
And that plus registration, right?
Yes.
So do you want to recommend this for
discussion?
And then add
it up.
Add $100 per out-of-town residence.
Yep.
Okay.
What about weekly rate out-of-town?
$700.
week's notice for attendance. And then out of town, pay by week is 70 or 75 per week. $70 per week.
We didn't have a lot of Tuesday families. Yeah, and we had 9 single out of town kids last summer and 3 two kid families.
And then 65 for the second child?
So that would have 135 a week. So the only other thing that we might have to talk about, which I think we've all kind of had a lot of numbers thrown out, so maybe this will be our last discussion if we have any more.
I think that does include plus money because it's the 360.
Yeah, the 360 included at 45 included buses, right?
So $55.
Yeah, 45 did include buses.
$5
would be $100. Yeah. We'll cover the bus. Yeah. So then the other thing we would look at if we wanted to flip back to teen camp about an out of town fee for that too. So this might be a really good thing for the Marshwood kids because I don't think they have anything like this. But if we're going, so now, I mean, this is when it really becomes critical, the thing about numbers, and, you know, because if our top for our 20 kids is 110, we could go 125 for out of town?
No, they're out of town.
125.
We can charge more for basketball.
Well, what all we're doing though is summer, the reason I picked that was that would be $15 a week more, right? So we charge $100 a week or $100 for the whole summer. So if you do that division, that's $12.50 more per week for Camp Raleigh that we're charging out of town. People.
You're way too nice.
Yeah. So maybe we need to do that and out of town people then.
Oh, you're not gonna meet your fees. When we put the numbers together, out of town fees help offset the difference.
Right.
So if you wanna make your in town fees 100 and your out of town fees 150, I think you're gonna be better off.
That's per week. So that's a $40 per week.
Well, if they love wrong for so much, they can move.
Or start something up with
that. My friends come here. Well, if we have our 20, so if you were asking for an average on that, would be 110.
Yeah.
Or 105. So if we put it at 7 weeks, yeah, it roughly comes to $15 more per week, that, like we did with the summer in the camp, probably camp.
Do people look at it?
I'm trying to follow the conversation.
Maybe we just need to
I'm thinking of like 135 in the middle between the two of your places.
For 130, we go 110 for town, in town, 130
or do you have any cover your costs?
I think we should keep it to the 140.
For which one?
Out-town.
So what would be the in-town, 110?
Yeah.
I'm good with that.
140 per week.
Because that's what you had estimated before, right? It was a...
And then...
Well, and that actually changes numbers for the week. I mean, if we go 15, say we have 15 rooms for kids, right, at 110 a week.
All these numbers will have to, like, have to...
11.5.
These numbers have to support our expenses.
Right. So if we have 15 rooms for kids, that...
So you're taking out kayaking, you're taking out the most expensive trips.
Yeah, we're taking out the more expensive trips.
So...
So if we did this, so here's a...
Okay.
So if we have a 15, if we have 15 rooms for kids, let's say, times 110 for the week, times 70, that comes to 11,550.
I can't look at numbers anymore.
It's 1,650 for a week. For 15 kids at 110.
1,650 per week at 110. For 15 kids?
Yeah. And then if we counted the numbers, if we got 5, it would be 700.
And that would be the money for other, like,
my photographs.
That was awful.
You with that, Celia?
I think so.
Can I make a little new one?
I'm gonna leave it in your hands.
Which hand?
Your hand. To put together whatever weeks you want. How's that? Is that something you would want to do?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, absolutely, I'll do that.
Okay.
Sounds good.
So, just, pick and choose where you wanna put what on what week. And I can start making up the registration forms.
Okay.
Can I ask a question?
Sure.
Are you still getting trust on Tuesday?
We are right now, is what we.
It just messes up especially.
Where would it be about a day?
Any 3 days that we can have in a row helps. Because then our kids who go to camp don't miss their summer special ed.
So.
We can change our days, we've done it before. We used to do Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. And then when Maureen was doing Thursday trips, they switched to Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. But then last year she went to Tuesday trips, so we had a bunch of kids missing their services on Tuesday.
Right, because the pool can't move, so that's all
right.
Pool can't move. So then our only other option would be Monday.
So that's up to you guys, because then we could do Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday,
right.
And not have any issues with.
Are you allowed to tell me how many kids from camp are?
I don't know.
Okay.
Oh,
we have to change that for you.
Yeah, do you know what the conflict was last summer? I know.
There was probably 5 or 6 kids.
So they go all day?
No.
Okay.
We only go, it depends.
Okay.
We go until like maybe 1 at the most usually.
Okay.
The latest.
So who thought to move? There are enough buses for teen camp and Camp Raleigh with
from
students?
We almost can't
do that on this Friday.
With
I would leave Friday.
Yeah.
Yeah, Friday they were there because their partner's camps.
Right.
So the only other option is move the field trip from Tuesday to Monday, but that would be next week's conversation. But we'll think about it and see what we can work out.
You guys don't want to work Monday, Wednesday, Thursday?
No, I don't think they do. It's hard for kids that have OT, because they're coming one day, and we don't get to dictate her day, because she works in many districts.
Right.
So, for years it's been Tuesday.
Oh.
So, all of those kids who have OT that went there, and would miss their OT time, or speech is also only one day, so it would either be speech or OT Tuesday.
I'm not saying you're at 8.
Well, some kids do.
Your slot is 8 and 9, because of us leaving.
Some kids we've had, one of the kids that I had came in early, and then on those days. And then she didn't know how much time she was going, or more. But I do have to say that it's much easier getting kids and returning kids.
Yeah, they're already there.
This year than it has been in the past.
Oh, great.
In the past, you have to go find them and where are they. And well, this year, I would just tell Brittany or Janessa, I need so-and-so, and they knew where they were, and they would get them for me. And
that's great.
That's good.
It's awesome.
It was much easier.
So you're going to work on working out today, so scheduling hot work on the.
Do we want to keep the camp Monday, Wednesday, Friday? Does anybody have any objections to that?
That doesn't make sense. I mean, I'm going to do that with that. There shouldn't be any 12-year-olds.
Right.
I mean, there could be one or two. And we get a couple of Marshwood kids, you know, our kids that go to Marshwood, but that's not.
Yeah. My thought was, my only thought of putting it Monday, Wednesday, Friday was like a puppy.
Somebody talked to me too about staffing, like if we're looking for somebody.
Can I just say, I believe the last thing on the agenda was whether or not we should be doing alternates. I think.
Oh, people.
I think we should cut down based on the attendance record, the number of people on the committee. If that's okay with the select board,
the select board can change that. I'm with it.
And when it comes to appointment time, change the alternate, because I don't think the alternates have attended. Our alternates would be Denise Knoll, Shana Jarvis, and
Denise Kelly. No.
And
Denise can't come this one. Yeah.
And Kelly Kane, I believe, is an alternate. So those would be our three alternates right now.
Kelly Kane doesn't really want to attend anymore.
She's not right here. Right. Okay. So, I would recommend moving at least Shana off of our alternate list and maybe moving either Roxanne or Blake to the alternate list to the next one.
Can you put that in an email for the board for Monday's agenda?
Yes, but I wanted to modify the chairs before I. Because the consistent people who have been coming to the meetings have been Kelly, myself, Dan, Dee, Kathy, and you. So this is an alternate right now. This is an alternate right now. She never officially resigned, so she was listed as an alternate. And then
did we put it out there asking for more people, more volunteers? Is that what?
Yeah, that's
Lori
has
to
do.
Kathy's
dragged. Kathy's dragged.
And then
ask dragged. Yeah.
I think she would be great. She has a lot of knowledge.
Connections.
Mm-hmm.
Would you be interested in joining her?
So how would she go about doing that?
She sent an email to the board asking to be placed on as a single member. And then we can appoint one member.
I didn't know if we were waiting until March to be doing the. Oh, when you do all the regular appointments?
Well, you don't. Well, right now you have open because why? But there's an option. So
yeah.
You can leave her as an alternate, you can bring her on as an alternate, you can leave her as a guest for a minute,
mm-hmm.
You can. Whatever you guys would like.
So, I can give this to you if you want, but with our current resignation in November, we have an opening, and we're having a hard time finding a quorum.
Right.
So I figured if we dropped a couple of our current alternates and made these two alternates, that would leave us six people, and then we'd only have to have four to have a quorum. Because you have to have 50% plus one, if I'm not mistaken.
Okay. That's fine. We can put you on as an alternate, so you don't have to be heard as any.
But Kelly's going to drag you.
She is. If she does my hair, she'll find out you're happy.
Make a special formula.
And
give her a verbal letter.
They can't say about that.
The email list that I checked in with Suzanne to make sure Lester had come off of our email list.
I'm not sure if I asked you. She said,
gave us her email. And she can put it in.
Okay, so we'll make sure we take that and all too. Can you send more of that? What do you want?
Okay.
That's what I was saying, oh, about the beginning of the meeting, I forgot to put the list of the overtaking.
This off the email list?
Yep.
These are already open. This one, and this one. Are already open.
Mm-hmm.
So we don't need to make any other changes, because. But we have more than that, wait.
No.
No. Because these two are current committee members.
Oh, you, oh, I thought, okay, I see anybody, okay.
So.
She's a committee member.
She's a currently alternate.
Okay, so we're making these alternates, we're making her an alternate, and we're taking you off the list.
I can't say
we know what they're talking about.
Yeah.
Do you want to drop this one, since she died council meeting?
Yeah.
She's currently the head of the CTO and has her hands full.
Yeah.
She's a currently an alternate?
Yes.
Yes. I want to check with Suzanne, but I don't know if I can ask somebody to check.
Or, I'll go check. Now, we'll drop this one, since we haven't seen her in over a year, for me. But,
Kelly.
Kelly.
Yes, I will double check. Send the email to Suzanne, and I will, and in the email, just ask where, I think we are, but
I will send it from the board chair and the ex officio.
Yes.
And I can send it to the school board.
Yes.
Okay. Does that make sense? It'll be in their email boxes.
And it's just to make sure that we have court.
And,
and I never wanted to try anybody to join me, even if they can only make the phone calls. But yes, and then in a year.
And it would still allow these people, these two, to come when they can and get input as
yes.
Alternates?
Yes.
But then we won't be struggling for corn.
Correct. Yes. Yes, because they both have been very good.
And then I have to go to the select board chair. I'll just you.
To all the select board. So Mike has an idea of what we're talking about, too. So it's just easier to email all of us.
Always. We make sure.
Because then we say, yeah, go to the select Monday night market. I didn't get that. I don't know what you're talking about.
So, meeting, next meeting.
Can we go to January, please?
Yeah, it'll be January. I am traveling January 5th through the 13th, and no, I wish I was going to Puerto Rico. Well, I don't know if I wish I was going to Puerto Rico, but I'm going to Florida with this custom team again, yeah.
So I have time with 6th and 7th too, so
And I can't do the 14th either because it's between the birthday, so
21st?
So the 21st, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Is that okay with everybody?
Yeah.
All right. You are? Where are you going?
I'm
going to be in West Palm Beach.
At 7 p.m. here?
Yeah. 21st.
Unless otherwise. Somebody send me an email if I need to change the place of the date or the time.
I'll tell you right now, right? Because we can't talk about numbers anymore. Really, I didn't.
Well, we got all that done. Like, we got a lot of consideration.
Yeah. So I will put some of this into a spreadsheet.
That would be fabulous. We
you can figure that out too. And I'll just keep talking, I go sitting at the basketball game.
I know, she's a good actor.
I do have good actor.
Can we adjourn?
Yes.